And now, reporting for Outside the Lines, Bob Lee.
Thursday, yet another concussion lawsuit filed by retired NFL players was sent to Philadelphia federal court to be bundled with a growing list of similar actions. At least one law firm has a prime commercial position on Google's search page looking for new plaintiffs. Already several hundred former players are suing over what they say are the after effects of concussions from their playing days, and they claim the fact that the NFL hid the dangers from them at the time. The sizzle in these suits is the name value of the plaintiffs and the depth of their health issues. And on both counts, Jim McMahon is a star plaintiff, the champion quarterback from the Super Bowl shuffle season with the Chicago Bears, a player who exuded attitude to the max. As Steve Delsohn tells us, Jim McMahon's state of mind today is very different.
McMahon rolling right, looking to throw, not buying time. Hop fly, foot upside, McKinnon is out there in the end zone.
During his 15 years in the NFL, Jim McMahon was irreverent, defiant, and always willing to challenge authority.
You guys watch the damn film, see if I can't take a hit.
His teammates called him Jimmy Mack.
McMahon steps up, now he'll take himself.
But the public knew him as the Punky QB.
Stay over there! Touchdown!
This is Jim McMahon today, 52 years old, still charismatic, still in his trademark sunglasses, but clearly a different man.
How is your short-term memory these days?
Short-term memory is not good. I won't remember a hell of a lot about this interview in about 10 minutes, probably. I mean, that's Lori.
There are days that he gets up and he comes into the kitchen. He doesn't know why he went into the kitchen.
Lori Navon is McMahon's girlfriend and lives with him in his Arizona home.
He's going to the mailbox, and 20 minutes later, I see he's still in the kitchen, wandering aimlessly around the kitchen, and he said, where was I going? What was I doing?
And that's when the anger kind of comes in once in a while. He's like, you dumbass, why are you doing this? What were you doing this for? Why are you in this room,
Hundreds of retired players, including McMahon, are suing the NFL, saying that it failed to properly treat concussions and concealed information about their long-term impact.
Well, we knew what was going on with pretty much every other part of the body. I mean, we knew there was going to be a chance for injury, but we didn't know about the head trauma. And they did, and that's the whole reason for this lawsuit.
When you were a player, clearly you were willing to take on the league. And you're taking on the league again, in a sense. Is this personal at all for you?
A little bit, because, like I said, I am affected by this. They knew about it, and they didn't tell us. That's just like flat-out lying to you, just looking you in the face and lying to you. And I don't put a whole lot of stock in those kind of people. And if, the league gets pissed, it's not the first time they've been mad at me.
McMahon was the swaggering leader of the 1985 Super Bowl champion Chicago Bears. When then NFL commissioner Pete Rozelle fined him during the 85 playoffs for wearing a headband with a corporate logo, the next week he wrote Rozelle on his headband. During Super Bowl week, once again McMahon took center stage.
I don't know what to say to you guys, I thought I'd been good all week.
Publicly blasting the owner of his own team and shooting the most famous moon in NFL history at a news helicopter during practice.
The thing was buzzing around, he wouldn't leave, so, we were stretching anyway. I just happened to be bent over. I was just scratching myself.
Vikings coming on a blitz, McMahon back to throw, hurls it deep down the middle, Willie Gould is out there!
But for all his NFL achievements and antics, McMahon took a physical beating.
How many concussions do you think you had while you were in the NFL?
I know for sure I had three. But I don't know what they deemed concussions back then. There was only three times for sure I knew I was too whacked out to really know what I was doing. I know the Packer game that we played when Charles Martin picked me up late after the play and dumped me on the top of my head. That one I know for sure was one of them.
Walk us through that play. What happened on that play?
I was just throwing a quick slant. I threw it down low. it actually was picked off. The DB made a heck of a play. Our guy touched him, plays over. I watched this whole sequence. And the next thing I know, I'm getting grabbed from behind and dumped on the top of my head.
All I know is somebody grabbed me from behind and threw me down.
Was that a flat-out dirty play?
That's the only way you can describe it. I still can't believe it happened. And people that have watched it couldn't believe it happened. I'm lucky he didn't paralyze me. What he was thinking, I don't know. Maybe he had some brain trauma. Who knows?
In 1988, the Chicago Tribune reported that McMahon injured his head in a game against Detroit. Afterwards, the Bears trainer was quoted as saying he had a concussion, but it cleared by halftime.
That's a typical response, it cleared by halftime.
Yeah, what do you make of that? How does it?
Well, back then, you know, it was, you know, if you could follow the guy's, the doctor's finger or the trainer's finger, you know, that was pretty much, okay, you're ready to go back in. You know, you got a headache, here's an aspirin, you know, tape it to your helmet, eat it, whatever you want to do, but, you know, you're ready to go back in.
How does that make you feel today when you hear that he had a concussion, but it cleared by halftime?
That's obviously somebody didn't know what the hell he was talking about.
I play with pain.
After 15 years in the NFL, countless hits, and 18 surgeries, McMahon says his life today is mostly sedentary.
My body's going to start locking up. We got to go in the house soon.
How about things like running, working out? How active are you today?
No, I haven't ran since I left the league. Ain't nobody chasing me anymore. I'm not running. I do play quite a bit of golf. I try to work out at times, but there's just days I can't.
Couple bushes out here.
But his girlfriend Lori says she is more concerned about his brain.
He got a Kindle for Christmas a couple of years ago because he loves to read, but there are many times he downloads the same book, and not until he's halfway through that he realizes that he already read that book.
Like phone calls, you know, guys will leave me a message, and I'll erase the message thinking I'll call them right back, and then I forget who just called me.
Does that bother you?
Well, if it's an important message, yeah, it'll bother me.
How much do you worry about him?
I worry about him every day. I program the GPS in the car with the home address, so if he ever does get lost, he can find his way back home. You just don't know what's going to be in 6 months or what's going to be in a year.
It's going to be real scary when it gets to the point where I can't find my way home, you know. Dave Duerson was struggling with that.
Like his former teammate, McMahon, Dave Duerson had sustained at least 3 documented concussions in the NFL. Last year, Duerson committed suicide. He was suffering from chronic traumatic encephalopathy, or CTE, an incurable brain disease caused by repeated blows to the head and linked to depression and dementia.
I'd seen Dave a month before. He seemed, you know, he wasn't as boisterous as he normally was, but, you know, I would have had no idea that, you know, it was that bad that, you know, he wanted to end his life like that.
What was your reaction when you heard that he had killed himself?
Shocked, disbelief, but that's what happens, you know, when your brain starts messing with you, you don't know what to do. I hope mine doesn't get that bad.
Jim, when you see guys who you played against or with who are struggling with things like dementia, how sad is that for you?
It breaks your heart, man. You get a guy that you've known for years and years that, you know, he can't recognize you or doesn't have any idea who you are or anybody else is. I mean, that's tough to deal with. There's some guys that are doing great, other guys are not. Other guys are really struggling, but, you know, we just try to keep each other up and just keep living, man.
Steve Delsohn reporting. Jim McMahon describes his current financial state as, quote, pretty well off. He says he is participating in the suit against the National Football League, not because he needs the money. We did invite the NFL to provide a guest for today's show. The league declined, but the league did issue this statement. The NFL has long made player safety a priority and continues to do so. Any allegation that the NFL intentionally sought to mislead players has no merit. It stands in contrast to the league's actions to better protect players and advance the science and medical understanding of the management and treatment of concussions, end quote.